Welcome back to PGA Chain Design Channel. Today we are going to look into this really popular loop twisting bangle, and then we want to look also into how to make the ending nice and smooth and with a really round cap. Are you ready? Let's get started. If you haven't heard about the membership program, please consider to join it. Click on the join button and that will show you what is in there. For a small monthly fee, supporting my passion to help other people to learn jewelry design. So don't hesitate and click on the join button here below. We're going to start at the front view for a bangle size. I'm going to use the ellipse command from the center and type it 0 there. I want it to width to be 30 on each side. So holding the shift and going up somewhere around here. The opening is depends on the design that you want, and I roughly want it to go something like that to be symmetrical. I want to make sure it's mirror to the other side. Roughly about 30 millimeter will be fine. And then we want to use the trim command to trim that off. So that will be the bangle size for us. Now, going to the top view, I like to know what is the length of the bangle. So we're gonna use the command length, and it say 133 and 965. Just gonna make a copy, and we are gonna coming over here to draw anywhere, and for the length is exactly the same with the bangle. And let me move this one back to the center. So using an align center tool and just type it 0 there. So now we have this there. I'm gonna hiding this bangle size first. So let's look into here. Depends on your design. If you want them to be super symmetrical and very even, here's what I will suggest you to do: a divided. I'm going to divide it into 5 section. And then all you see is the dot over there. So now I'm going to use the arc tool and snapping into this point. I want something come over just a little bit over that middle point. So roughly about this size over here. And if you feel like this is really wide, you don't like it, you can always using the gumball to do 1D scale. Okay, so then the next things I need to have this curve coming up there. And I want it to come up really nice. A lot of time when we just use the curve to draw, it always give us a kink over there, and that doesn't look really nice. So what I usually like to do is I would like to draw a really short line right there, a straight line. And instead of trying to draw the curve in between, I like to use the blend tool to blend from this end to that end. And all I need to do to be symmetrical is mirror that to the other side. So you can see there's no kink there and it's really smooth. All right, so then we can go ahead to join them. The next things that I wanted to do is I want to rebuild this curve. The reason for rebuild is we were able to get them into one single curve instead of a multiple section there. After we do that, we wanted to pipe it and make sure that we don't need the cap. We want a cap is equal none. And I just want it to be over, just a little bit over to the other side. So it's a little bit overlapping there. The reason we want to record a history is we could just rotate this one. Again, not mirror, it's rotated. And we want to copy equal yes and coming over here. So then we got something flat. Let's take a look on the perspective. Because we record a history, so if we turn on the control point right there and we pick up the curve nearby, and we can lower this curve here, and everything will update automatically, as you can see right there. And if you were using mirror, when you try to edit the point, edit exactly on the other side instead of the opposite side. So that may be something you want to pay a little attention on that. So if you like this one, we're going to do the end over there. Normally, if you want to trim each other, they has to be two different pieces. So what I like to do is I'm going to use the split command. And I'm going to split with the middle line first. And as you can see, after I split, those piece is already split over there. Okay, so once I have that, all I need to do is join back. Next step, let's go ahead to use the fillet, and we want to do something. In my case, it's about 0.5 here, and let's give it a try and see how it look. So we're gonna pick up there and there, and make sure you want to pick up every single one. So then you will have a smoother transition. If you feel like this transition is a little bit too small, either you can go with the bigger size. Let's try something really big for 1.5. And again, we want to pick up every single one there. And you get something like that. But unfortunately, you can see it's kind of a breaking over there because that little break section over there. So another way that we can do is we can come over here and we want to use maybe a rectangle. And we want to make sure that rectangle is right in the middle. So using the horizontal align to the zero. And with that, as a cutting tool, we want to trim the surface in between the middle. And that's did it, this rectangle. So all we have is a big opening there. We can use the blend command. We're gonna blend, make sure that chain edge is equal, yes. We wanna blend from here to this part. And again, you can adjust your blend to be more narrow, higher, or whichever you think is going to work for you. So one thing you can do is we can using this patch command, and we want to select all the edges there, not the point, and we can preview it and see how puffy you want it, and you click OK on it. Let's join all of them and take a look on this and try to take a look. The thing is, it's not joining it. If it is not joining, mean some of the area, as you can see, there's a gap there. Okay, so the other way to try is to duplicate this edges right there and try to join them. So when we duplicate the edges, we can make sure the curve is exactly on top of the edges. And we want to split this one into two halves. So that's split at the quadrant and also at the quadrant as well. Then we want to creating a profile in the middle. So that's snapping into the quadrant here. And also the quadrant there, and bring up a curve over there. If you feel like this curve is too much, too bump, and then you can move in a little bit. Okay, so now what we like to do is using the surface command for a sweep to rail. This will be the rail one, this will be the rail two, and we want to go from the point to the middle one and go back to the point at the end. So then you will get this really nice and puffy looking end there, right? So let's give it a try. Let's join this. And it shows it's a closed solid polished surface. Okay, so now we can, instead of doing all the way on the other side, which I already did it the other side, and we can, again, do not mirror. We wanted to rotate it. Copy equal yes, set it up at the zero and bring it to the other side. So now we have this ready. If you feel like this is a little bit too fat and you want it to be narrow a little bit, if you have the record history on, you can continue to edit it if you want to. So that's it. This is what I like, and I'm just gonna using the Boolean union to make it into one piece. All right, let's bring back with the ellipse that we had earlier for the bangle. Now we are going to use the command. It's under the transform, and you have flow along curve. You're gonna pick up your object first and click on your base curve and click on your target curve. Let's hide this one. So this will be our bangle with a nice join in the end. I hope you join the membership program and see more exclusive video for member only. See you there. Thank you.